Did you know that 2 out of every 3 guys will experience some form of male pattern baldness by the time they're 35? I know it. For me, it was more like 25. I wish keeps had been around when I was younger because advancements in science meant that there are now treatments that can combat the symptoms of hair loss and help you keep the hair that you have. Look, it's too late for me. My hair is not coming back, but you didn't have to be like me. You can stop your hair loss early. Thanks to Keeps. Keeps offers generic versions of the only 2 FDA-approved drugs for treating hair loss. So you might have tried them before, but never at a price this low. If you were thinking, oh my God, Simon, this is medicine, it's gonna be expensive, you couldn't be more wrong. Keeps starts at just $10 a month. How does it work? Well, for one thing, you don't need to go to the doctor's office, just schedule a quick online consult, and a bit later, discreet package arrives, and you use it in the privacy of your own home. So if you're noticing that you're losing your hair, that's a problem that's not going to solve itself, do something about it. For a limited time, go to keeps.com/top10s or click the link in the description below to receive 50% off your first order. And now today's video. In his 1865 poem, When I Heard the Learned Astronomer, Walt Whitman describes how listening to the proofs and figures of astronomy leaves him less fulfilled than when he looked up in perfect silence at the stars. While we don't really agree with the idea that facts and figures inherently drain the wondrousness out of the universe, we can certainly empathize with the sense of speechlessness and awe when contemplating worlds beyond. Not a year goes by that Earth satellites don't find a solar system's worth of planets, stars, and other heavenly bodies that would be dismissed as ridiculous if a science fiction writer invented them. Some are bewildering in their composition, others mind-boggling in their scope, and yet others are milestone discoveries that trivial matters on Earth kept out of the public consciousness. All are worthy of our attention, so join us as we go through them today. Number 10, the space face. The mental habit of seeing patterns in arbitrary arrangements is called pareidolia, and it usually manifests as people seeing faces. Someone wouldn't need an especially advanced case to see a properly alien visage in this 2019 photo, courtesy of no less than the Hubble telescope. It brings to mind some image that would be shown at the end of a new Men in Black film to show how some alien being's presence is intertwined with the fabric of the universe. While we don't know yet if there's some entity that bears an uncanny coincidental resemblance to this face, the truth is quite awe-inspiring on its own. This is 2 solar systems colliding, specifically the Arcmedor 2026424 system, and they've been known about since 1987, despite being roughly 700,000 light-years from Earth. The blue that outlines the face are new stars that are being exchanged in the collision. Such an intermingling of galaxies is postulated to potentially last 100 million years, which, as we've seen in other lists, is quite fleeting in cosmic terms. Number 9, the Circumtriple Planet. We've heard of binary planets, which orbit 2 stars, but it turns out this is quite common. An estimated 40% of stars are in binary systems. If nothing else, there's the original Star Wars, which features the iconic setting of 2 suns. But a planet which orbits 3 stars, would that actually be possible? Well, yes. There's the GW Orionis system, located at the head of the Orion constellation. As reported by Jeremy Smallwood of the University of Nevada, Las Vegas, the first discovered circumtriple planets were found 1,300 light-years away in 2018. Especially surprising, the planets in this triptych are glass planets instead of rocky ones, which you'd think would be more vulnerable to being dissipated by competing forces. It turns out that an overabundance of solar winds in the GW Orionis system, which is about 2.5 times the size of Pluto's orbit around the Sun, keep the gaseous spheres not only intact, but orbiting on their merry, unusually complex way. Number 8, the Winds of Hell planet. There are plenty of planets which seem survivable by design, as have been described on other lists. K2141b, by contrast, seems designed to be invisible. The planet is 5 times the mass of Earth, and since it is so close to its star that a circumnavigation of the Sun takes only 7 Earth hours, most of that mass is lava. Most is not an exaggeration, as its molten oceans are estimated to stretch 100 kilometers down. While 2/3 of the planet's surface is usually somewhere around 3,000 degrees Celsius, the 1/3 facing away can plunge into startlingly extreme cold during the brief periods out of the sunlight. Reportedly, it often reaches minus 200 degrees Celsius. This temperature shock causes not only large chunks of lava to solidify and thus form fleeting continents, but unimaginably extreme winds. They can supposedly reach 5,000 kilometers per hour, which is roughly 4 times the speed of sound. Any satellite we could hope to drop on it would be vaporized within hours and become part of the planet's regular cycle of rocky rain. And speaking of rocky rain, rest assured, we're going to hear plenty more about that in the upcoming entries today. Number 7. Atmospheric Bermuda Triangle. Giving the impression that we have to look far into space to discover anything new and amazing. The fact is that we only have to go 124 miles from Earth to discover an energy shadow so mysterious that it's known as the South Atlantic Anomaly. It stretches from Chile to Zimbabwe, for reasons not yet known, for this patch of the sky, the Van Allen Belt, the magnetic atmospheric force encircling the globe, is much closer to Earth, and thus satellites orbiting the planet get bombarded by much higher concentrations of radiation, to the point where they're much more frequently damaged, to the point of radio silence. There is precious little that scientists can do to avoid such a large section of the sky, and a number of satellites just have to take the increased radiation from that treacherous journey as a fact of life, or maybe a fact of a half-life. For example, as reported by space.com, the aforementioned Hubble telescope moves through there 10 times a day, so much so that it spends about 15% of its time being microwaved. Number 6. Waterworld. Water is often treated as evidence that a planet is potentially habitable. But Gliese 1214b is so dissimilar to Earth in many other ways that the general rules of water don't seem to apply. It's similar to K2141b in that it's so close to its sun that it only takes 38 hours for a complete orbit, and it's 6 times the mass of Earth. However, because it orbits a red dwarf star, it's a much more manageable temperature, and thus it's covered in a layer of water. And yet, not water as we know it, because the atmospheric pressure and temperature on the planet are both so high that the water is in a permanent plasmatic state, and it's got intense electricity constantly coursing through it. Imagine an entire atmosphere lit up with lightning. Down on the surface of the planet, the superpressure results in crystallization that has been dubbed hot ice. Truly, there would be water everywhere, but not a drop to drink. Number 5. Gold rains. No, it's not just a special drink found at the most fashionable clubs. It's the bombardment of metal from space that accounts for our rich deposits of precious metals today. See, part of the reason that gold is so rare is that such a heavy metal did not occur very commonly in the sort of natural creation of minerals on Earth. As reported by LiveScience.com in October 2020, it was up to chemical reactions in stars, especially neutron stars, to create gold through the supernova process and send it to planets as meteors. For evidence of this, scientists have looked not up to the stars, but beneath the ground. In 2017, during an excavation in Desardo Massif in Argentina, deposits from 70 kilometers were being unearthed in unusually high concentrations through volcanic eruptions. Jose Jimenez of the University of Granada reported that this meant that the meteors that formed the Earth's rich gold deposits fell in the largest amounts roughly 200 million years ago. If you happen to hear that Venus has gold rains, don't make plans to go prospecting. That's just pyrite vaporized on the surface and freezing back into crystals like snowflakes in the upper atmosphere. That means it's more like fool's gold rain, if you will. Number 4. Diamond rains. If gold rains from eons past aren't your thing, how about rains of supercompressed carbon? It turns out the mechanism for this bejeweled weather is reminiscent of the situation on Gliese 1214b. Lightning, caused by friction between atmospheric forces, breaks down methane gas into lumps of carbon. This isn't a bunch of insubstantial particles we're talking about either, but pebbles often as much as a centimeter, roughly a third of an inch in diameter. As reported by Dr. Kevin Baines of the University of Madison, Wisconsin, and NASA, an estimated 1,000 tons of diamonds get made by this process in the gases of Saturn alone. That's tons by Earth standards, since the same rocks would weigh vastly more on Saturn, of course. This is by no means unique to Saturn. Both Uranus and Neptune were speculated to have diamonds, but it seems that the chemical composition of Jupiter makes it a uniquely diamond-poor planet among the solar system's gas giants. Not that it has none, they just get broken up quite randomly among Jupiter's fumes. Number 3. The cold spot. If there is anything the universe goes all out on, it's making gigantic stretches of nothingness. On this channel, we previously paid tribute to the Boots Void and its 330 million light-years of emptiness, but we've since learned that it's practically a gopher hole compared to one discovered in 2005. This super void has been measured to stretch for 1.8 billion light-years. Not for nothing has it been widely dubbed the super void. You need to worry about ever getting stuck in it, though, as it's 3 billion light-years away. Since it's so deprived of stars and other matter to generate heat through a wealth of chemical processes, it has been found to be a huge contributor to why galaxies on the outer edge are much colder than normal. It's also worth noting that nature generally abhors a vacuum, and for most of the universe, matter is fairly evenly distributed. Thus, it is no exaggeration to say that the supervoid is likely one of the universe's biggest mysteries. 2. A giant comet. Comets, as far as we know, usually aren't that big. Halley's Comet, for all its fame, is a fairly small 9.3 miles wide. Then, when the summer of 2021 rolled around, a comet came to humanity's attention which puts all previous ice balls to shame. The Bernardinelli-Bernstein comet stretches a robust 124 miles wide. If you're confused how you didn't hear about this heavenly body that dwarfs Halley's, is in no small degree because it wasn't visible in the night sky. It won't be visible from Earth by the average person using consumer-grade equipment until 2031, which means if it comes closer to Earth than predicted, as has happened before, such as in October 2021 with asteroid UA21, it could light the sky to well over 10 times brighter than any other comet ever has. Number 1. The Moon Cube. Here it is, something much closer to the monolith from 2001 A Space Odyssey than any of us would have thought possible. On December 3, 2021, the Chinese lunar rover Yutu 2, on its mission to explore the south pole of the dark side of the moon, and fresh from discovering such curious moon sites as moon stalagmites and rocks fused together, photographed a large square boulder. Initially, China's National Space Administration nicknamed it the Mystery Hut. It was taken sufficiently seriously that the rover controllers changed the course. This is no casual trip we're talking about here. Since the rover has to rely on solar recharges, it will take more than 2 months before it comes close enough to the object to take a more definitive photo, even though it was estimated to be only 40 miles away from the Mystery Hut when it took the first photo. At present, the leading theory is that the unusually symmetrical boulder got blown out of the moon's surface by a meteor impact. Killjoys have speculated that it's not really very distinctly shaped at all, it kind of just looks like that because of the camera's pixelation. Whatever it is part of a mission which has already produced mountains of data which will be invaluable in better understanding Earth's nearest solar companion. So I really hope you found this video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below, don't forget to subscribe, and as always, thank you for watching.